Reporting from Arkham Asylum, this is Gotham Rogues. In this video, we spotlight Heath Ledger's Joker from the movie The Dark Knight. It's another episode of Batman Movie Villains, and we're now at the Joker, played by Heath Ledger, in Christopher Nolan's The Dark Knight from 2008. But before I get into the video, I want to mention that I did an interview about my channel and Batrogues in general with a writer from the website Gong. A link is in the description below, so you can give the interview a read if you want to. And now let's take a look at Ledger's Joker. In the movie The Dark Knight, we're introduced to a mysterious figure known as the Joker, who's lately been rapidly rising in Gotham's criminal underworld. The Joker makes a deal with the city's leading mobsters to kill Batman, played by Christian Bale, of course, who's a thorn in their side. But in actuality, the murderous clown schemes on entirely different plans. Joker holds a strong belief in a philosophy that is a sort of blend of nihilism and anarchy, viewing the world as chaotic and people's attempts at control as a joke. When Batman arrives on the scene in Gotham, the Joker is fascinated by this character, a man who dresses up as a bat and goes his own way, not caring about rules. The arch-villain grows obsessed with the Dark Knight, discovering that he does follow one rule: no killing. The clown then makes it his mission to force Batman to break that rule, at the same time as he plunges the city into chaos, trying to prove to everyone what the true nature of man is. So for the Joker, Nolan did exactly what he had done with Ra's al Ghul and Scarecrow in Batman Begins, radically changed the character to fit in his realistic and grounded Batman world. This Joker only wears makeup, he's got no laughing gas or joke gimmicks, and employs an array of ordinary firearms instead. He's also not a supervillain, but instead referred to as a terrorist. This Joker isn't really the funniest either, he's less of a comedic clown, and more reminiscent of a Joker from the playing card deck, unpredictable and immune to the set rules. This is actually very similar to how the character was portrayed in his first appearance back in 1940, the playing card thing I mean. Then we have the nihilistic worldview, which is very reminiscent of a Killing Joke graphic novel. So Nolan did actually stay kind of true to the source material. For the character's portrayal, he basically combined the first appearance with the Killing Joke, which in turn created something new, but that's still unquestionably the Joker. In the movie, Joker is, I guess, what you could call pure evil. It really depends on how you look at it, though. In his eyes, he's not really evil. Instead, he's the only one who's actually honest. This is what makes this take on a character so damn fascinating, this philosophy of his. It's quite similar to how Nolan handled Ra's al Ghul. Both of these villains don't really view themselves as villains, but instead as the only ones who can see the world for what it truly is, and the only ones who's prepared to do something about it. I guess that's why both admire Bruce so much, because he's also like that. Ra's and Bruce's end goals are far more noble and optimistic than the Joker's, however. I find Ra's al Ghul's beliefs and Begins to be incredibly interesting, and like I said in the video about him, I think there's at least a possibility that he's right. Well, it's the same thing with Joker in Dark Knight. I don't like his message, but he could have a point. If society crumbled and all rules disappeared, how would we act? What would we become? And if someone did to us what Joker did to Harvey Dent in the movie, would we react the same way as Harvey did? It's really impossible to know until it actually happens, and that's a real frightening thought. Heath Ledger's Joker is not a sympathetic character, but a really fascinating one nonetheless. The fact that he's motivated by this idea, and goes so far to prove it too, that's really crazy. He's essentially a fanatic, but not a religious one or even a political one, but a philosophical one, I guess you would say. That's a lot more interesting than a villain who's motivated by money. And of course, that's a big thing in the movie too. Joker doesn't give a shit about money, and even states that clearly several times. He was unlike any criminal that Batman had faced in his film series. All the mobsters and the Scarecrow wanted money, and Ra's al Ghul wanted the same as Bruce, justice, although through completely different means. Those Batman could understand, but the Joker is a bit trickier. He doesn't even make any sense at all first, but if you actually listen to what he's saying and observe what he's doing, it becomes clear that he does have a goal. He isn't just total randomness. He does claim to be a few times, but how could he be? If anyone's a schemer, it's him. Randomness does tie into his philosophy though, but he himself is one calculative son of a bitch. I think it was a wise choice to make the character a mysterious enigma. We know nothing about him, who he is and why he believes the things he do. We get no origin story, and that's a good thing. It's also common with the Joker. He did get one in the 89 movie, and one was suggested in A Killing Joke. And then there's the lovers and madmen storyline, so it's not like giving the character an origin ruins him. But when it comes to this take, an origin would have ruined him, I think. He's way creepier and effective being a complete blank. So Heath Ledger's performance. He of course won an Oscar posthumously, but do I think he deserved it? I'm gonna have to say, yeah, he definitely did. I wonder though, if he hadn't died, would he still have given it to him? Because the Oscars can be pretty political. Anyway, Ledger's performance as this Joker is just absolutely fantastic. There's no trace of Heath Ledger on the screen whatsoever. Due to the heavy makeup, obviously, he doesn't look like Ledger at all. But he also doesn't sound like Ledger. In all other movies I've seen him in, he's got a fairly deep voice. But here, his voice is kinda high, soft, and nasal. He also doesn't use the same kind of facial expressions and body language that he usually did. It's like it's not really Ledger at all on the screen, but some entity that only exists within the confines of this one movie. As for the design of the character, that's another aspect that's very different from what we're used to with the Joker. Usually the Clown Prince of Crime is a stylish dandy, but here he looks like a dirty hobo. He's got long stringy hair, a weathered dark purple coat, and the nastiest teeth you've ever seen. That's not how I generally want the Joker to look like, but it fits this version like a glove, as the grungy design goes perfectly with the character's nihilistic philosophy. The Glasgow smile also makes a lot of sense given Nolan's obsession with realism, and it's also a perfect alternative for the character. Then we have the makeup. It's funny, back in 2007 when it was revealed that Ledger's Joker would only wear makeup instead of having chemically bleached skin, I was one of those who freaked out. I remember I wrote on a forum that this way he'd be no more special than ordinary criminals like Carmine Falcone. That's very humorous for me to think back on. I did fairly quickly change my mind though, when I realized the direction Nolan was taking the character in. But actually, I don't really think that a permanently chalk-white Joker is too unrealistic. I mean, you had a fear toxin in Begins, and that's a fairly fantastical concept. So it could have worked. But in the end, I like the makeup just as well. And it fits the character too, that he just sloppily slaps on some makeup without giving a shit how it looks. In conclusion, Heath Ledger's Joker is one of the best movie adaptations of a Batrogue that we've gotten so far. I'd never call it definitive Joker, because like I've said a few times before, my Joker is a psychotic clown with a very morbid sense of humor. This Joker isn't a clown per se, as it's more supposed to be the Joker from the playing card, and he also isn't as funny as I'd like. I mean, he's not humorless, there are definitely funny bits, just not that many, and a lot of them are also kinda subtle, like the fire truck that's on fire. Get it? Fire truck? Nonetheless, it's a very fascinating take on a character, and it was exactly what we needed back in 2008. It wouldn't have worked with another Nicholson or Mark Hamill Joker at the time. We needed something fresh, something brand new, that was still very much indeed the Joker, and that's exactly what we got. I couldn't have been more pleased with this portrayal back in 08, and I still couldn't be. So there you have it, that's Heath Ledger's Joker. Next up on Batman Movie Villains, we'll be taking a look at Aaron Eckhart's Two-Face, also from The Dark Knight, so stay tuned for that. And remember, Arkham Asylum awaits you in the next video.